Hello, it's Ricardo and welcome back. Today I want to talk a bit about Windows 11. Now, recently I've upgraded my PC to an Intel i9 and the motherboard is an Asus ROG Strix motherboard. So a gaming motherboard and all pretty new and swanky. So I was a bit concerned when all these rumors came out that I may not be able to install Windows 11 because my machine might not have a trusted platform module or TPM chip on it. Now, this is complete and utter baloney, and I will show you why it is complete and utter baloney, because even though it's turned off in the BIOS, you can turn it on, and I'm going to show you how. So finding this facility within the BIOS was a big sigh of relief, and with a little bit of research I found out that the trusted platform module or TPM for Intel is something called Intel PTT, which is Intel's Platform Trust Technology. Now in the BIOS, by pressing delete and getting into my BIOS, I was able to, from the main menu, to go to the advanced tab. Now, this is where you're generally going to find this facility to turn on PTT or TPM. So the advanced tab, that's what it's all about. Now you see I've got it enabled. With it disabled, that's probably the default standard of all manufacturers that have shipped their motherboards. Set it to enable, however, and you get the notice to pop up that tells you exactly what it is. Intel PTT is a hardware TPM 2.0 implementation integrated into Intel processors. Now typically what's happened is that all machines less than 5 years old, approximately, have had this built in. Not only Intel chips, but also AMD chips as well. So, you may well be very lucky. I mean, my old PC, no, that's got TPM on that, 1.2. It's not going to be good enough, I don't think. Microsoft specifically states they want TPM 2.0 or equivalent. So, for me, with this PC, my Intel i9, fantastic. Tick in the box there. I can enable it. Click on save my settings, reboot the machine, and I then get a security module showing up in Device Manager. Now, Windows 11 does come with some quite stringent prerequisites. I mean, a processor 1 GHz or faster, RAM 4 GB. You know, system firmware, this TPM module or PTT module, but a graphics card compatible with DirectX 12 and a definition display of 720p. And I think most of us have probably got something at least a little bit better than that. Now, there used to be a checker that was on the website for this, but unfortunately that's been moved away because it was causing a bit more confusion. How to enable TPM on your PC is also listed off the Microsoft website, and you can see by going into the Device Manager you can also check where it is and how to enable it, and it also goes through brief sections on how to get into it in a generic BIOS method. However, what they do say is that you can also check in the Device Manager. The Device Manager lists all the devices that are on your PC. Now, a lot of us will know this, although a lot of us will not. By going into Device Manager, if you scroll down and just past the processor section, you may well be able to see security devices. Now, because I've already implemented my PTT or TPM function in the BIOS, this is showing up. Before I had done that, when it was disabled, there was no such function there whatsoever. So, tick in the box for me. As soon as Windows 11 comes out, I may well install it. Or shall I wait for that first update? Who knows? Let me know in the comments if you found this useful. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already done so.